Okay guys, welcome back to our golf course design, or design our own golf course. I'm probably not going to do parts anymore. Like, the initial idea was to do like part one with the whole one, so on and so forth, but we ran into trouble when we were doing 4 and 5. We ended up, we didn't have any audio. And I'm just currently checking right this very minute, and it seems as if we have audio. The last one we built was hole number 6. In fact, I might just get rid of those markers there, because we probably don't need them. Clear out. We built hole number 6. Which you can see there's a kind of, it's a fairly... quite a long approach. I think it's about over 200 yards into the green. So what I'm going to do is, I'm actually going to build 3 holes today. I've actually got a concept for a hole, which is going to be the 9th. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to quickly build 2 sort of bog standard basic par 4s. I think we need, what do we need, 4? That gives us 28. Yeah, so we need 3 par 4s to finish with, the front 9. So I'm really just going to do 2 bog standard par 4s, and then the 9th will be the hole that I want to try and, I've got in my head at the moment. Well, I've actually kind of written it down as well, but, so let's go and create, let's see, I'm trying to think where we can make the tee. Mate, I don't know where that actually whoop back. Yeah, maybe tee this up roughly about here, and then just head back down to that portion down here. What we got. $250. Unless we just, do we see if we can squeeze this in here. Because we could probably actually put the tee in that other side, so maybe go about 390. So you always, you open up more land to this side. Right, you probably actually open up more land as you go further out, but... Right, what we're going to do is... I'm going to quickly bunker this up. In fact, I don't even know... That's a bit of a dry point there. Because these bunkers can actually act for this hole as well, which is quite handy. Let's sculpt. Let's quickly do some bunkers here. As I say, I don't want to spend too much time in these holes, or these two. Let's get some bunkers in there. Maybe do another one here. And then maybe just, now this one's actually going to act as a double bunker. It's quite good actually closing up two fairways quite close to each other, because you get that kind of unique feature where they almost act as like a pair. Now let's bunker this up. Let's put one in here. We're keeping these bunkers roughly the same size. You don't need to. One in here, it's quite a deep one. And then maybe one just slightly off the back here. Right, there we go. Alright, and let's get the bunkers in. As I say, this is kind of quick, because these holes, I just want them basic. That's the wrong one. I want to create a bunker. And then we're just going to put these in. Resize that. Oh, wrong way. Again, pretty quick because we're just probably going to spend more time designing the ninth hole than we are these. I mean, these will just be two kind of bog standard. Oh, God, if I'm getting this in the middle. Bog standard par fours. I see nothing too fancy. Just quick and easy. Oh, there you go. Why is that not going? Is that because, is that too deep or? I'll probably get back to that bunker. I've obviously went too deep with that one. I think maybe because it's got a rocky bottom. But anyway, that is one of the quickest par 4s you'll probably ever see getting made. Pretty basic. Right, let's go to the next hole, which again is going to be a fairly basic affair. Okay, hold, right, we want to swing this round, let's get down a little bit, and then we're basically going to tee up here, and we're just going to go straight up. Might even just kind of go off a little bit, 2.5, 2.60. Maybe go 4.34 in between those two sort of hills there. Ah, right, okay, I see a problem there. Well, I kind of don't see a problem. It's actually maybe going to work out not too bad. Because we're driving in about this direction. We'll probably keep that. I'm probably going to leave the bunkers for this one till later. Right, wait till we see where we want to go with this hole. Right, we kind of want to maybe just come in this part. Maybe even come down a bit here. Maybe just a bit here. Right, now, this hole, I've kind of got the idea of a kind of risk-reward type hole. Almost like a kind of double fairway. I'll maybe try and sketch this out just now. So we want to go at least maybe 225. Right, we'll go a bit there. Right, let's see where we want to go. Is there any contours we want to? I want to go at least. See that there could be quite nice, but I want to go at least about 420. Just pan out. I don't know if I want to go. Probably actually just in a bit there. Right. Well, initial go. We'll go here. Right, now what I need to do is, right, we need to go back here, we need to adjust the fairway, edit hole, right, width, now we need to go down to narrow, basically so there's no fairway, because we want to put in our own fairway. Right, we need to throw a marker up here, I need to see. Right, let's get some distance here. Find out where we are. Right, this side will be the short. Right, we need to go about, what is it, 225 yards as a 5 wood. Right, so I'm reckoning 225. What's the carry for that? 10 yards, say? Maybe go 240. Right, let's go back to the tee. And maybe just go slightly to the. So we want to go. Driving distance is 245 by 3 wood. Oh, wrong one. 245. That's carry. So let's say 240. And then we make the fairway up here. Right. So what we're going to do now, we're going to put in some fairways. I can explain what I'm trying to do as we build it, because I could sit and describe how I want the hole, but to be honest, we'll just start putting in fairway. Let's see. I'll go to create surface fairway. Alright, we want to pick. I don't know whether some of these are too. I don't know. Let's see what size this is going to be. Right, we'll take that back, because I need it. I don't know if I need it slightly bigger. We might just add. Oh, where's my. Oh, where'd my tools go? Right, okay. Can we go back? Damn. Right, oh, that. Can we actually go forward, or is that going to be lost forever? Right, okay. So that was handy. I just deleted the hole that I just created. And what is that doing? Why that did that? Right. Now where did we tee this up from? Is that it there? And we'll make it here. Right, we'll just go for 20 yards. Basically. Probably. Right, we'll go there. Oh, we've done that. Nah. Man, I'm really. It's not going well at the moment. Right, try that again. So I didn't set my fairway length 240 and then out to 420. Right. Oh god, I tell you, sometimes it ain't easy. Right, let's go back. Right, get that narrow. And then we're going to throw up some markers here. Distance, there's a distance there. And again, we want to go from here. Zoom out a bit so it goes faster. What did I say? 225 is the carrier, 3 wood. So, 5 wood, sorry. So there's carry. I reckon maybe 10 yards, I think 240, right? Then we go back. Then roughly we do the carry for this. And then the carry of 3 wood is, what is it, 245? And we want to be rougher coming in a bit here. Well, maybe a bit there. Right. Let's go back to where we were. So we want to add fairy. Right. I don't know. Try this one. I don't want it to be too big. Let's put that in, see what it's like. Try and get it in line with the T. That's about right there. I'll keep that shape. I think we need to go to this just generic straight one. Because we can always add a bit more in. Right, let's go roughly where we need this to be. Right, where's my green? My green's up. So we need to go maybe that. Right, let's put that in. Much bigger. Could probably actually just make that a bit there. Keep it in line. Right. Because we can always, I don't know if we can maybe shape that a bit more if that's the size I want. Let's try and throw some drives out here because I need to get the kind of length roughly to where I want it. Let's play this hole. Because the idea here is that I want a hole that it sets up almost like a kind of risk reward. I may have to make that fairway a bit narrower. Maybe. Right, let's take a 5-wood. The 5-wood's going to land in this area here. Now this would be the kind of safe shot. The only thing that you get with this will be you're going to have a long approach, and that's just about perfect. If the wind's behind, you may have to club down to like a 3-iron. See, 179 yards to this green. And I might change the green so that it's kind of difficult to get on, maybe. Let's just play an approach in here, just see what it's like. See what kind of roll we get. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty... that's kind of bog standard there. So what I might do is make it quite a narrow green so that still maybe gonna have to put a bit of let's rewind shot and rewind again. Right, now we take the driver. Let's take a 3-wood. So here's the other fairway here. You can probably see what I'm trying to get with this. But I need to make it so that could actually squeeze that fairway up quite a bit. And I might make it a bit narrower, it's just too wide. So let's see where we are. Yeah, we're quite a bit up there. I don't really know whether to bring a tree into this equation. Or bushes or something just to tighten it up. Right, we need to make that fairway, we need to adjust it slightly. Because it's too, I'm going to say it's too easy, but. Right, let's edit. Because really what I want is, I want to make this green as well. I don't know how to make, can I make that green a bit harder to hit? I want it so that if you tee up and you play this bottom option, you've got a long approach, which means that you've got to be really precise with your approach, or you're not going to be in the green, basically. So I'm maybe even thinking about having the green shaped a bit more for the kind of TGC size. I guess if I make this small, I could probably just make it. Yeah. Right, let's add to green. So I want to make it a bit more shaped towards this angle here. So maybe if you put bring that down a wee bit. And then bring this here. Now that might be too weak. Let me bring this round, shape it that way. Right, we'll get back to that. Right, we need to bring this back a bit, or forward, I mean. Can I just put rough in there, or is that... No. See, a rough is always... Your fairway always takes, like, the top rank, if you know what I mean. We need to delete that. We could move the fairway, but multi-select. I don't know if that's deleted that. Like, we need to maybe select. Keep that bit, we just need to delete these two. Right, that's worked. Right, let's come out here. Let's just go to the, I know where that thing is. Create an add. Right, so we need to move the fairway up just a bit. Again, I'm just going to keep this shape. I may actually make it thinner. I think this, maybe we need to be a bit here, roughly. Right, let's play that, because we can adjust, but we can only adjust this, if you see where we're actually hitting the three wood. Right, let's get this three wood going here. And it wanna be kinda up and over a little bit more. Right, let's see. Well, that is gonna be tight. Right, you can maybe just add a tiny fraction to that. Right, let's rewind. Now let's take our driver. That needs to be further over. Right, that might be just about right. Not a bad drive. Now this should easily clear it. And I like that tightness. I don't want it to be like super wide. And that's about perfect. See, Nats has got 138 yards to the pen. Let's see, 7%. That's probably going to be short. Yep. Right. Let's not worry about that. Let's get back to the course. Right, that fairway, the right hand side of the fairway, I think is just a bit perfect. We just need to add just a tiny, tiny, tiny amount to this portion here. It's not going to be much. I might even do a different shape, to be honest. I don't know about some of these straggly ones that are a bit. But that's just going to give us a nice. Let's see what it looks like. Let's go maybe just a tiny, tiny, just a bit there. That just adds enough. Right, now we need to delete. I'm going to delete this other bit of the fairway because I want to get a different shape and also a different width into it. I want it to be tricky, to be narrow, but not be like stupidly narrow. Multi-select. Select. I think I'm actually going to delete this portion here as well. Because really what I'm trying to do is just get this bit established first and then we can start moving up. So I'm probably actually quite liking that sort of style there. Now you can do it here. Add to fairway. Right, probably I might just rotate that round a little. Maybe keep that shape. Yeah, I can make that narrow there if we don't. Right, let's just sneak this. How's that looking? Yeah, that's pretty. Might just go with a different shape as we get closer to the green. Let's put that round there. I mean, this is all pretty much obsolete fairway anyway. Let's just angle this. Let's maybe choose that, maybe make this the green surround, i.e. the fairway. Right, that's probably about right there. I want to keep this fairway actually fairly kind of large to a certain extent. Right, we're going to place, I don't know how to place bunkers, I'll go with some form of, let me think now. I don't know where to add. Let me see, we've got rough. Alright, like that. Right, okay. Just trying to work out the heavy rough. This, oh, what is this area? Yeah, probably create an ad. Can I just make this all heavy rough? I see that can only be. Take it that can only be. I can't delete that because that's the actual hole. Okay, okay. That's kind of annoying. I'll put in some light rough here. Go in there. Probably actually better go into a straight element tool because I can get it shaped a bit better. Because I don't want the rough, I don't want the heavy, I want the heavy stuff to be there, but I don't want it to be. I don't know what that is. Is that like a shadow? Maybe just have a bit of. Just trying to shape this rough in. I'll probably go for a circle round the green. Probably actually okay at that. Right, I don't know what to put in. I mean, bunkers are bunkers, but. What do we want? I don't really want to put trees in, but I kind of feel I need something just to separate this a little bit. What have we got? Global. Signs, bridges. Let's go theme. I mean rocks. I don't know. I'm. I feel I want some form of. See grass. Cause you don't really eat. Well, you do get trees. But you can get a type of tree on kind of like it's got, but it's not abundant, it's not something that's. So I kind of like the idea of that. No, they're too big. See that's. Like a bit of a gossy type area. What do we want? What do we want? Oh, I'm trying to think here. It's not good when you think in your feet. So we're going to be hitting a three woods going to land really just about here. And also drivers maybe going to be up about here. I can actually make that quite small. Right, okay, put a couple of these in just to kind of. Because we need to break this up. I'm just going to mark this out, actually. Because this area, I might just put some of these in. And then put some rocks, just to kind of, like, almost like separate those two fairways. But I need something in here that's going to make this risky, this shot. Try and think here. Let's see what rocks we've got. Maybe just like putting a whole kind of rockery in there type of thing. I don't know if there's... I mean, obviously we're gonna populate this with the gorse bushes. Right, let's do a bunker. We'll sculpt a bunker. Sculpt. Right, we'll pick. I think we need something that's gonna be a wee bit bigger than your standard. And right in here, let's scale it back a bit. Just anything that's really short here. I want it to maybe catch this bunker. Right, let's drop this down. 9 feet. Right, that could be good. And again, for this, it's almost going to be the same type of bunker. I want it to be quite big. Oh, wrong way. So we need two runoffs there. I might even, is it possible just to join that up a little bit? Maybe make that smaller. Zoom in a little bit. Be good. Just to kind of link those two up, almost like a, you know, a series of bunkers running here in a kind of S shape. Right, we need bunkers. Maybe make these ones kind of oval. Right, we need a big bunker, just maybe, just right in about here. Might need to undo that, because I think if it goes down to rock, you can't put sand in for some reason, so maybe 8 foot. Yeah, let's just have another one. Maybe make this one smaller. Maybe two smaller size bunkers. Right. 8 foot. And then another one just right in here. And then we're going to put a bunker in just here, because it's just begging for a bunker. 6 foot. Right, make this all... Probably make this area here quite gorsy and rocky and just a lot of trouble. Maybe even over here as well. And I'm probably going to try and fill this area here. Make that kind of sort of... glossy, wild, try and make it authentic wild, but not stupidly, if you know what I mean. Now let's get some bunkers in here, probably one just right there. And another one just here, maybe even make it into the fairway. Maybe this one a little bit bigger, actually. It's right, when we're driving here, we need something, maybe one just here. And... maybe one just up there. Right, that's probably looking not too bad. Yeah, I'll get to the green later. Let's get to fill these with sand. I think we can actually just create. No, we don't. Oh, we do have bunkers. Size that down. Rotate it round. Trying to get these roughly about where we need them. Get all these pop bunkers done first. It's probably the easiest way of doing it. Drop this one in here. And then we've got one, another one here. Just zoom in a little bit. Maybe make that one at the back a little bit bigger. That's better. Right, we've got this horseshoe type affair. Let's get another. It's too much. We'll go with this one. Because again, we can shape these a good bit. Yeah, it doesn't really. Sometimes it doesn't add too much to it. Pan out, that's actually not too bad. I can actually get one in probably this way. I could probably make this one a bit bigger. Just trying to get these lined up. I'm kind of concentrating, that's why I'm maybe not talking as much. Probably see that's a bit perfect. Right, I quite like that. Right. Trying to think if that's pretty much what we want. Right, let's maybe. Now let's play. Let's get a feel for it. Because I say if we've made mistakes, then we can adjust a little bit. Yep, so there's the three wood. I imagine this three wood's going to be quite tight to that. Man, that's scary. But that's what I want. I mean, probably, let's just see if a three wood would actually make it. If you add wind element into this, it could really make it butt-quenchingly tight. Oh my goodness, that's risky. Anything really short of that's in that bunker. Now let's rewind, I'd probably have to drive it anyway at this hole. Right, this is the real. Kind of right up in that choke point. I mean, that's a tight drive. You've just come off of two easy holes there, two easy par fours, so I really want a tough driving hole, and that's pretty good actually. Maybe put another bunker just up above us there. Right, it's really about the approach now. Oh, that was short. Well, 96% of a. Let's rewind that. Let's try again my full 100% shot. Yeah, we need to just add a little bit. Right, so let's just add a smidge. Yeah, I mean that's pretty much, the green's quite receptive. Oh, I do rather to make the green maybe a little bit more trickier. But that's a tap-in birdie there. Yeah, let's rewind. Let's rewind again. Right, let's go for the 5-wood option here. Which is basically just straight up. This might actually roll quite a bit. Any kind of wind in that's gone, basically. See now, instead of having like a, I don't know what we had in there, 9-iron, that other fairway was about 130 yards, which is, let's just see, yeah, that should be about a 9-iron, I think. We've now went the bottom option of the fairway, and we've now got 179 yards, which is a completely different kettle of fish. I just want to see how this was the whole reason about turning the green so that it's a bit more angled that way. Right, we've not got a lot to play with here. It's 11 foot up, 179 yards. Right, let's just hit this in, see what happens. So it's a longer iron. Yeah, I mean, the greens are quite receptive. I may just make these greens just that little bit. I don't know if I make this green firm. I don't know if I can set different greens. Because I don't want it to be. To see its size flag. No, it's not giving me the. Let's go to. I think it's layout, and there's the greens. Right, slope. Speed, firmness. Right, I think we need to go. Let's just move it up to there initially. Right, what else can we do? Speed, yeah, they're kind of fast. Right, let's play this. I want it to be really that. Kind of forces you to play the whole, to play a driver, to get as far up that fairway as you possibly can, and have a shot, a kind of a softer landing shot into that green. And if it's quite, in fact, let's just go there. Let's go back with the 5-wood. Let's take a bit off it actually, because I think we're going to go too long anyway. So this is the easier shot. I say I want to get that side maybe. Couple more hazards, make it a bit more tricky looking. 242 yards, so that's about perfect. See, 179 yards in. Now what I want from this, remember that last shot we played with about actually, I want this to run. I want it to be so difficult to hit this green. Yeah, that's better, that's what you want. So let's rewind that shot. And see what kind of shot. I'm probably going to have to put some loft on it. Let me put that much. Right, let's see. Let's do this shot. Yeah, I mean, that, see, that's still running to the back. I mean, I'm probably actually going to have to put a water, sort of waft on it. Let's just move it over a little bit. That's exactly what I want. I want it to be so that, I mean, if you're playing this course for the first time, you're going to guesstimate a shot. So your chances of getting this on the green pin high, and are probably like an easy birdie, are going to be quite slim. Which is what I want from that side. So now you're on the tee, and you think to yourself, well, I could take that. I'm going to take that other side on. Let's go with a driver. Let's get this lined up. Let's maybe not use the, I would say that's roughly about right. So we need to hit a really straight shot here. Ooh. Right, risk reward. That's, potentially that's a fantastic drive. And then we've only got 138 yards. We're hitting a 9 iron into this green. It's 11 foot up. So maybe just need to put just a touch on the extra power. And let's pull this in. Because we're going to be coming from a higher elevation. Yeah, we still go to the back, but it's not as much. Let's just rewind. Okay, let's just hit it normal. Because the greens are firmed up. Let's just see. Oh man, that's super tricky, that hole. That could cause a bit of grief. Oh, that wasn't a good shot there. Tree wind. Let's try this. Yeah, I mean, we could probably do a lot of different shots there. Even something like this. Oh, that's right. Okay, I need to put three, that's better. I mean, a shot like this might even be better. Just draw it in a little. Use that green a little. Yeah, I quite like it, but you've maybe got to sort of shape a shot a little bit. You know, it's not like, it's not just so obvious. Let's put a big. Let's try and put this one in. Yeah, that's almost. Yeah, I quite like that. I think the green's quite fair for that type of shot. That's quite a soapy green as well. Right, let's go back and edit. Right, probably need to make, this is probably going to be quite a long video. Right, let's go, I think I need a bunker. I think I need a bunker just up, roughly about here. Maybe just in this portion. And maybe just one up here. Right, as for, I don't know where to put bunkers round the green. I might put one here, or a couple of pot bunkers just in this portion, because if you're short with that approach, especially from the kind of safe area, then these are going to catch you out, which I think could be quite good. So I'm going to put two there. Maybe just some bunkers off this runoff area, just in case you maybe do hit one wrong, maybe one just back here. And then just one here, just for, I suppose just for safety. Yeah, let's get these bunkered up. You do that one. I like my bunkers to sit fairly flat. Yeah, that's better. Let's run off here at the back. Here, and then these two down here. This one a wee bit bigger. That's the whole kind of sort of fleshed out a bit. As I say, what I really want to do is something here in this area. Whether I sculpt, you know, raise the land, lower it, make it bumpier, I don't know, just change it, modify it a little bit, because it's not, you're not going to weigh up, you're actually going to go for the green, so this is kind of just sort of wasteland, if you know what I mean. So I'm going to put something in here just to make it rustic. And the same with this bit here, I might make kind of rocks, kind of rockery out this bit here maybe. I'll put bushes and just make it kind of quite wild looking. Gorse bushes, trees, not trees, but kind of low kind of wine bushes. And do a bit here, but I'm pretty happy with how this has turned out. As I say, from the tee, you're going to make two choices. You either go for the safe shot, here and have, you know, like a 180 yard, 175, 180 yard approach. And there's not much green to work with, so you're really going to have to land it pretty much here. Maybe just to get it there. So you're maybe not actually going to go on the green. Or you go for the riskier tee shot, drive it over here, three wood maybe is going to be here, but it's not going to be far. Driver's going to be landing up here, but again there's risk here and there, it's not going to be easy. And then you've got like maybe a 9-iron approach, and probably an approach you might have to bend in a little bit, a bit of draw. To get it in, maybe come in with this. So that's hole 9, that's the front 9 done, out in 36. Quite happy. Probably maybe even the next video, I might even incorporate, I don't know how to put some bunkers in here, like one here. But I'm just going to do that just now. I was going to do it a different way there, but sculpt. Oh, wrong one. Now let's just make this just a tad bit bigger. Let's just Put that down. And let's get the bunker. I quite like the idea that that's like a double fairway, double bunker type scenario. I think that's quite good. Look at this one. Make it bigger. Like, can I even... Oh. Sometimes the keys here, you get so... Move over to the fairway. Can I make that all fairway? Oh. Yeah. Okay, that's... I quite like that, actually. That's a wee kind of quirky thing there. Yeah, basically, kind of got like almost double bunkers here. Yeah, I quite like that. Yeah, just too basic. So, what we've did today, we did 7 and 8 are just basic par 4s. Kind of actually meet up with each other, which I quite like. I like the fact that they're kind of both merged into one in the middle. Basic 8th is just a basic par 4 as well. And then we've got this kind of risk reward par 4 here. I'm probably actually going to go off screen and kind of just muck about with this a little bit, maybe try and get it kind of a bit nicer looking, but that's basically the front nine done and dusted. We'll start with the back nine. In fact, actually what I wanted to do is add a lighthouse at the ninth hole, start at the 10 so we know where we are. Okay, add. Right, I think it's global buildings, and then there is a, I think there's two lighthouses, there's this one, that one, I think that's it, I think there's two. Yeah, so we'll probably, I quite like this one to be honest. Maybe just gonna pop it here. There we go. And that just gives us a bit of a kind of visualization. If you go all the way back here, you can see that in the distance. There's a clubhouse there. Just a bit make out the lighthouse in the distance. So that's a front nine. Get a big double green. We're going to incorporate this double green when we come back round. We'll probably play into it. So we've a top and bottom tier, which I think is quite nice. And there's the lighthouse, and that's the end of the front nine. So next we'll do the back nine. I'll probably get thinking, I'll probably do a couple of basic holes after the ninth there, so 10 and 11 will be maybe start off with a par 5, and then do some basic par 4s, and then we'll come up with a kind of nice par 3 and a nice par 4, maybe put a bit of effort into it as such. So guys, that's going to that's going to conclude this video. So join us for more design our own course as we'll complete the back nine. We'll get that done and dusted. I don't know whether to maybe play the front nine, maybe put that video up just to see what we get, how we play it. And that'll do it, guys. So once again, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later. Bye.